Understanding the least significant difference. Utilizing SAN research results to help make decisions on the farm is a wise business practice. It can be confusing, however, when you see two numbers that are clearly not the same, labeled as not significantly different. What does this really mean? One can quickly calculate the value of a few bushels per acre over hundreds of corn or soybean acres. It is key to look at just what this terminology means and its practical importance when using this information to make decisions. First, consider why research is conducted in the first place. Research is usually conducted so we can use the results to help make the best decisions possible in the future. We want to use practices that have a high likelihood or probability of paying off. A term commonly used in research is the least significant difference, or LSD. In a hybrid variety trial, for example, this is the minimum bushels per acre that two hybrids must differ by before we would consider them to be significantly different. Note, there is no way to calculate the LSD if a person simply splits a field in half and puts one treatment on one side of a field and a different treatment on the other. In this scenario, you have no way to sort out if a difference in observed yields was due to underlying factors such as topography, soil type, drainage, compaction, or fertility, and so on. Things like weed pressure, fertilizer or application issues, planter issues, or insect damage are also sources of variability that can impact yield results. A well laid out trial where we randomize and replicate treatments helps account for underlying sources of variability and allows for calculation of the LSD. The LSD is calculated at a specific level of significance. When you see the LSD calculated at the 0.05 level, for example, this means we can be 95% certain that the treatments, or hybrids, or practices, and so on, really did differ in yield if the difference between them was equal to or greater than the LSD. The significance level of 0.05 or 0.1 are most commonly used in agricultural research, although you may occasionally see it calculated at the 0.2 level. How do we end up with no significant difference? This can occur when there is so much variability in the results due to other factors that we can't make a conclusion with confidence, or when the treatments or hybrids in the study simply don't differ in yield. Results from a University of Minnesota tillage trial demonstrate the importance of statistical analysis in helping determine if a yield difference is likely real. At this particular site for the study, average corn yield for strip tillage was 10 bushel an acre greater than in mulberry plow. Yield was not statistically significant, however, so we couldn't say one tillage system resulted in a higher yield than another. This is noted by the NS for not significant in the table. Closer examination of the data shows how much variability was found in yield among the treatments. Each column of data represents a replication, or rep, of the treatments, and the shaded areas represent the highest yielding treatment within a rep. Note that while strip tillage out-yielded mulberry plow in the first rep by 13 bushel an acre, mulberry plow out-yielded strip tillage by 14 bushel an acre in the fourth rep. Also, chisel plow was the lowest yielding treatment in rep 2, while it was the top yielding in reps 1 and 3. Due to this variability, we couldn't say with confidence that any of the tillage systems resulted in a higher yield than another at this site. Other factors we couldn't account for appeared to have impacted results, highlighting the value of conducting research over a number of locations and years. One last key point to emphasize is that if fields are not statistically different, don't treat them differently. Resist the temptation to put economics to average yields if they are not significantly different. Doing so could lead to poor and costly decisions in the future.